leaking. Everybody knows the captain lied. Everybody got this broken feeling, like their father or their dog just died. Everybody talking to their pockets. Everybody wants a box of chocolates and a long stem rose. Everybody knows. Everybody knows that you love me, baby. Everybody knows that you really do. Everybody knows that you've been faithful. Everybody knows you've been discreet.
Yeah, I can smell it. I can almost taste it, the rankness in the air. It's everywhere. It's running through that old pipeline out there, trickling along that dumb concrete river and coming up through the drains of those lovely tract homes we all live in.
So who is he? He goes to Humphrey.
I mean, I don't know. Everywhere I look, it seems everything is sold out.
They say this is where the reception is the coolest.
Then he probably lives right around here.
Fucking yuppies.
My dad sold out. And my mom sold out years ago when she had me.
And then they sold me out when they brought me to this hole in the world.
Hey, they made me everything I am today, so naturally I hate the bastards.
Speaking of which, I am running a contest on the best way to put them out of their misery.
Tonight we have number 12 of 100 things to do with your body when you're all alone. Now, are you ready for the incredible sound of Hard Harry coming on his own face?
Oh my God. It's very possible, you know. Oh.
Are you listening to this?
Yeah.
Of course I'm listening.
This guy's got
to have hair coming out of his palms.
Oh, this is a champion one. Oh, yeah.
You listening?
Yeah, I'm going
He's
blind.
He's doing it. Oh, my unreal. God, oh, my God.
Still growing.
It's...
Yes, Hard Harry will go to any length to keep his three listeners glued with Ooey Bluey to their radios, but...
Question is, how far will you go? I mean, how far can you go to amaze... and discuss the insatiable Hard Harry, huh?
I mean, how serious are you? I ask you that.
I'm beautiful. Listener. You know what I can't figure out? How you managed to get such great grades and you listen to that radio all night, you know? Tomorrow, don't forget Yale interview. And I don't want you to look too sleepy, you know? Good night, sweetheart.
Starting to get a lot of letters here, guys. Weird. Dear Hard Harry. My boyfriend won't talk to me anymore.
How do I show him that I really love him? Like, I don't know anything about these letters asking for love advice. I mean, if I knew anything about love, I would be out there making it instead of sitting in here talking to you guys.
So, just send me stuff at Box 2710, USA Mail, Paradise Hills, Mesa, Arizona, 84012.
Reply is guaranteed. Dear Harry, I think you're boring and obnoxious and have a high opinion of yourself. Of course, some of you are probably thinking I sent this one to myself.
I think school is okay if you just look at it right.
I mean, I like your music, but I really just don't see why you can't be cheerful for one second.
I'll tell you since you asked.
I just arrived in this stupid suburb. I have no friends.
No money. No car.
No license. And even if I did have a license, all I could do is drive out to some stupid mall. Maybe if I'm lucky, play some fucking video games, smoke a joint, and get stupid.
You see, there's nothing to do anymore. Everything decent's been done. All the great
themes have been used up, turned into theme parks.
So I don't
really find it exactly cheerful to be living in the middle of a totally, like, exhausted decade where there's nothing to look forward to and no one to look up to.